Okay, I've known him for almost 20 years. And he's one of the probably few people who actually did double PhD. So he was actually doing the first PhD in Haifa in Israel in pure mathematics. As far as I remember, it was probably a group one topic of the group theory. And then it was in 1996. And then in 2001, he actually finished PhD in cryptography in computer science in University of Wollongong. And then he had a few different positions at different universities, or the city university in Hong Kong, probably in this place, and also postdoc in various universities. In probably 2003, actually, he joined for a few years Macquarie University in Sydney. And then in 2006, he joined the current university he's working in, Nanyang Technological University, and he's throughout the whole time, he's actually doing a lot of interesting stuff on the edge of cryptography and also combinatorics and mathematics. So he will talk us through his own adventure over the years, and welcome, Professor Wang. Give him a good hand.
Thank you, first of all, for the nice introduction. And save the program committee of Asiacrypt 2017 for giving me the opportunity to give a talk here. So today I'm going to talk about combinatorics in information security cryptography, some application. So first of all, I would like to say for you, quite many my co-authors who collaborated with me and in different projects under this so-called combinatorial cryptography. Few of them are here, and then is here, Joseph is here, Ivo is here, and Louis is here, Duncan is here. Okay, thank you. Okay, so. Okay, so here's outline of the talk. First give a brief interview of the connection between the combinatorial and crypto, provide some detail example of the connection between perfect hashing family, sequencing scheme, geometric alloy, and traditional cryptography. And then I go to the carbon free family and their application in secure communication. And then, if time for me, I will talk briefly two more examples about secure multi-party communication in private information retrieval, and then I will conclude the talk. Okay, so we all know that combinatorics is a mathematical subject that study of finite or countable discrete structure, and they cover a lot of topics, for example, graph theory, enumerative combinatorial, combinatorial design, mature theory, and so on, and many, many others. They also have many applications, okay, apart from the mass application, there are applications in, for example, statistics, computer science, engineering, communication, coding theory, cryptography, optimization, physics, and so on. Okay, just listen to you, example. So in terms of this close connection between the combinatorial in cryptography, starting from public key cryptography, the well-known left-side problem, left-side-based public key. Also, it provides this combinatorial MP hard problem for the design of PKC, okay, green group-based cryptography hard word problem are all this combinatorial nature. Okay, zero knowledge proof is based on the graph isomorphism problem, so on. For symmetric key cryptography, we also a lot of sequences are combinatorial nature. Okay, so hashing function S4S. Even for quantum cryptography, it might be combinatorial features might provide a useful tool or insight for the quantum cryptography. So in this talk, I'm going to focus on this information security cryptography. Okay. So I also give a very overview, a brief overview of the different connection. One example is authentication code, unconditionally authentication code, also called ACO. We know this orthogonal way, BIPD, are equivalent to certain optimal, this ACO. Okay, can use this combinatorial technique to derive a different information theoretic bound or combinatorial bound for this code. Okay. Every Euclidean code or universal hashing framework, hash families are the sources for the code construction or ACO. For sequencing scheme, we know ideal tracer sequencing scheme is equivalent to MDS code, is equivalent to orthogonal way. Okay. Matrix theory provides the useful structure for the sequencing scheme for general X-structure. Okay. Also, this graph-based X-structure provides the first example for the existence of no ideal sequencing scheme, so on. Heat retriever pattern, a combinatorial design, carbon free family are all natural structure for the heat distribution. I've been talking about this mass scale multi-party computation, in particular, this MPC for long available group is based on this graph calling over planned graph, okay. Private information retrieval, different combinatorial object like a regular intersection family, perfect Huaxiong families are useful tool for this construction. And in many, many other topics in the information theoretical cryptography area, for example, secure write type code, SMT, brainproof code, one time signature, visual cryptography are all have this combinatorial lecture. Okay. So this is very incomplete in brief overview of the connection between combinatoria in the cryptography. So next I will look at the detail of some example for the connection for perfect Huaxiong family sequencing scheme combinatorial way in tracer cryptography. Okay. So perfect Huaxiong family originally arise as part of this combiner design, but recently okay, different application for like operating system, language translation system, information retrieval system, and more recently on like cryptography or information security. Okay, it's different from our cryptography hashing function. Okay, so the terminology of this perfect Huaxiong family is motivated by the fact that we have family of hash function and with a particular property that involves T element to be hash, then there is one function from this family give no collision for this keeping T input. Okay. So let's look at this mathematical definition. Okay, we have set we have two integers, n, m, okay. So typically this n is larger than m, and a is a set of this n element, and m is a set of m element. Okay. This h is a subset of a function from a to b. We call it an nmt perfect Huaxiong family. Okay. If for any t subset I, they exist, it is one function from this family such that h is 1 to 1 when restricted to t, where this is I. Okay. So this is the combinatorial property. And here we are interested in the number of this function from this family. Okay. The arrow. We particularly like this arrow as small as possible. So we show this example. So here is a figure to show you that we have collection of this function from A to B, okay. And for any subset, T subset I from A, if A is an element, then if I choose T element subset from that, okay, now I will able to find one of these functions from H such that, okay, this H will be straight to this particular I, this one to one. Okay, so obviously we can take all the functions from A to B. Now this gives you the perfect Huaxiong family, okay? And this time the size of this family, the total number of the odd function is m to power n. Okay. But the interesting thing is that by carefully design all this function, and for giving m and t, they exist this function, this family, such that the size of the family is O log of n. Okay. And this is the existing bound. Okay. In particular, we can come up with different constructions from polynomial, from coding, from design, or from algebra curve over finite Fourier. Okay. In this case, for algebra curve over finite Fourier can provide asymptotic optimum construction. Okay. The question, of course, you hear the quiz M and T. But some applications maybe MT are ready enough, good enough. Okay. So this is the okay, the concept for this perfect Huaxiong family. As I mentioned, I'm going to show some application for sequencing scheme. Let's briefly review the sequence, what's sequencing scheme. Okay, so introduced by Samir in Berkeley in 1979. So it's a method of distributing cells among a set of participants satisfying two conditions. One is the availability such that certain subset of participants, so belonging to the X structure, can reconstruct the sequence, and subset not belonging to the X structure has no information about the sequence. Here we are interested in the perfect case, that means no any information, no extra information. Okay, so a typical example is this T alpha N trivial scheme. In order to have the T alpha N trivial scheme, the dealer will randomly choose a polynomial of degree in most t minus 1 and hide the sequence in the constant of this, this polynomial. And then each partition will show one pawn of the polynomial. Okay. So any t of this pawn or this curve can block this curve and recover the constant k. Okay. Less than t minus 1, so not able to do so. So that means the information theoretical perfect without any information about the sequence. Okay, this is the classical sequencing scheme. Okay, so sequencing scheme idea is perfect, is great, but the question is, okay, sometimes we don't have such the ideal situation such that the minimum and also the subset is a constant sign, which means that the t minus 1 is the maximum and also the subset. Okay, every case. So let's to the so-called sequencing scheme for general structure. So how can we realize the sequencing scheme such that okay, the X structure is no T alpha N. Okay, no so regular. Okay. So this is due to so-called Combinatorics rules. Okay. So Combinatorics rule was introduced formally defined by Stevens in Jackson Martin in 1991, but eventually the idea was used by this Ito, Saito, and Szczesniki in the proof of the existence of perfect sequencing scheme for any X structure. Okay, in the 89 paper. Okay, so as I will show that this approach has not received much study in the context of sequencing scheme. And the reason is that the sequencing scheme from this Combinatorics rule typically give you very large size of cells. Okay. Okay, so let's look at what is the definition of Combinatorics rule. So Combinatorics rule, so we start with a set of n participants, P1 to Pn. Gamma is in X structure, okay, the subset of the collection of subset of P with the particle property that can recontract sequence. Okay. Now, the X, this X is is a set, okay, and S1 to SD, the D element set. Tau is a constant from P to power set S. Okay, and now we call this ST is a commutative alloy for gamma if and only if, okay, this condition, this means I is in gamma if and only if the union form of this TP, P belong to I, equals S. So in words, that each participant will receive a subset of this I, okay, and the collection of them can recover the whole set of this S if and only if they are in the S structure. Okay, so the idea is very simple. Okay, so now we can realize the secret sense came from a computer array in a simple, straightforward way. So that we split the secret sense game of using T alpha and T secret sense game, for example, K is S1 plus S2 plus SK here. And then you just take the same of P is a subset of this S1 to ST. Okay, and any of them can recover the full set, and you can sum them up together by the key. Okay, so this is the formal definition of ideal secret sense game. Okay, so eventually now in later on, Jackson Martin provided a solution to construct this cumulative array for any X structure. So given an X structure, now you take this gamma plus is the collection of all the maximum and also the subset. And then you define, this is X in our previous slide, so you have C1 to CD, and then you define this tau in this way, okay. For any P, tau P is a subset of this gamma plus in this way. And then they show that this is a cumulative array, is also the minimum cumulative array, that means what? This D is the minimum value for all the cumulative array realize this gamma. Okay, so we give the solution of cumulative array. Okay, so now you look at the previous T alpha N traces game, then you look at all the maximum and also that become T N choose T minus 1. And okay, in particular for this particular solution, each particular participant require N choose 1 minus T minus 1 piece of shape. Compared to the Xiaomi secret sense game, T alpha N secret sense including one piece. So this is very expensive. Okay. And as I mentioned, this is probably the reason that people don't look at this cumulative construction. Okay, so now in order to improve this cumulative efficiency of cumulative array, so in Martin, in us, including myself, we introduced this so-called GCA, generalized, this is CA. Okay, so what's it mean? A GCA is given an X structure. Okay, a GCA is a collection of this time of finite set X together with this tau P to tau set of SR. Such that this satisfies this condition. Okay, so I is in gamma if and only if there exists is at least one I such that tau I P, P in I give you this particular SI. Okay, so the meaning is instead of one block to cover the whole element in this block. So now we have a collection, a few copies of this XI, and then as long as you can recover one of this block, then we say this you are in the X structure. Okay, so we use a partial property to come to sum up to this this two different properties. Okay, so once you have this GCA, now we can realize construct a secret sense game for gamma in also. Quite straightforward. This time, we independently implemented this LO partial regression, partial CA scheme for the same secret. Okay, I will use the same secret to implement it the same as the privacy scheme for the CA. Okay, so now we can do the same thing. for the sequencing scheme. So now look at the, efficient example, the efficient of this GCA. So the GCA become long list. We originally have one block, and then we show that this Jack's Mason contraction is minimum one, it could be led to exponential. So now we have our GCA. So we look at, okay, so it's the number of the self-weight participant is the sum of this value, and the total of the cell generated is also this, all the sum of this block. So how now the question is, how can we construct this GCA with good parameters, okay, for any general structure? And this is, this is an open problem, okay? It's, we don't know how to have a good structure unless it's a GCA. But here we have this partial solution. Okay. So I will show you this one of the partial solution. I will use this perfect Huaxiong Wang method to construct this GCA. Okay. So what TR for N. Okay, we start with perfect Huaxiong Wang method with LONTT. Okay. And then for each HI define this XI, a block. And now we can define all this type. The tau are from P to SI in this way. This also what happened is for each block I will define for each user I will pick one point from each block. And how to pick up this, how to pick this block is based on the perfect Huaxiong Wang property. Okay, so now what happened is, now if for any T subset I know I can find one of these perfect Huaxiong Wang function such that it is 1-to-1. So give T element, I will give match to T element for one of these blocks. And less than T minus 1, because each user will get one point from each block. So T minus 1 will get the most T minus 1 block. So we are not able to recover any of this error block for this XI. Okay, so indeed, this is the TRN GCA. Okay, so then now here is the simple example. I will start with, this is so-called, this is a perfect Huaxiong Wang from A element to 2 element. Okay, we have three, this function. Okay, and because I have three function, I will create three block, S1, S2, S3. And each P1 will get one point from this S1, get one point from S2, and get one point from S3. And do the same thing for all the A element. And how can we exactly pick up people, which point we are going to pick for P1 is based on this perfect Huaxiong property. Okay, so good. So this is, and the idea is, this is interesting. I start with a T out of T. You can start with a T out of M, and then this perfect Huaxiong point become, P and L and T. Okay, and the underlying could be any other different object, for example, key distribution scheme, authentication scheme, web code scheme, any other thing. So you build this small one to the large one based on this perfect Huaxiong Wang method, as you can pin down the property and the related parameters, then give you, and the efficiency is provided by the efficiency of perfect Huaxiong Wang method. Okay, so in general, you can generalize for different things. Okay, so now to show the power of this this contraction, I give this example. Okay, So in Xiamian's 97 paper, he start with this motivating example, and this was the import from used the combinatorial book in 1968. Okay. And you have this problem. So 11 scientists working on a secret project, they wish to look at the document in cabinet so that the cabinet could be open even only if 6 or more of the scientists are around. And what is the smallest number lock needed, and what is the smallest number of key to carry for each scientist? So they can come up with a solution 462 and 252 keys. Okay, so you base on this tracer scheme, and this okay TR letter CA for this 6 out of 11 exactly the image this okay. The example in Xiaomin's paper. Okay, so now I will show you by GCA we might provide a bit better solution. Okay, so we start with the perfect Huaxiong family and define this way for A from 1 to N and B is 1 to 2 to T. So for each subset of I, I will define a bound selector. Okay, and then ST is Stinson in 1996. They show that this one is a perfect Huaxiong family with this particular parameter. Okay, with L over S, they chose this one. Okay, so now, so if I take this, we take this N equals 11 T equals 6, then we get perfect Huaxiong family with this particular parameters, and then we use GCA. As I just showed previously, and then we come up with a solution with 360 log and 56 keys for each statistic compared with the CA solution. And okay, so yeah, it's a little bit different from the original one. For the CA solution, that you only use this N log. But for GCA, you can use this N and O log, but both are mechanically implementable. Yeah, okay, so just show example to show that you might improve, okay, get something from this GCA. Okay, so as an application for this CA or GCA, I'm going to talk about tracer cryptography, some application in tracer cryptography. So we know the main goal of the tracer cryptography is to replace a single entity in a conventional cryptography system by group or entity, okay, same power. And a typical approach of constructing a tracer cryptography is you combine homomorphic key homomorphic primacy together with a linear sequencing scheme, okay, and then we are able to improve this tracer scheme, okay. But however, there are lack of some article property for. For example, symmetric cryptography map then rule out all such approach. So let's look at this homomorphic case. So if you have key homomorphic, I refer to key homomorphic, then it's quite straightforward to realize sequencing tracer cryptography. Okay. So for example, and then in this case, for example, you will share the key. Here is a homomorphic primitives. You carry this operation of key, in key space could be carried over to the for example cyberspace. And so now I can look first generalize this key use the K alpha in sequencing scheme. Okay, well the K alpha in linear sequencing scheme that I mean this secret key can be the some linear combination of the secret. Okay, and then what happens is you, in order to generate the LKM, then every user, for example, PI1 will compute this one, PI2 will compute this one, PI2 will compute this one. So you don't need to compute, you find out this K in order to generate the AKM. Okay, so this is the linear case, the homomorphic case. Okay, so as I said, there's no, there are crypto primates that you don't have this homomorphic property. Example include this PRF and block cipher mark. I will give you the, this some example. So, for example, in 95, this Mikali in Sydney asked this question. Okay, so. To share a generation of pseudo number function among n participants such that for all input, any US can compute this LS, T of U players cannot do so. So they want the scheme is basically the follow. So you distribute a secret key x1 to xd of a polyrandom collection of functions, and let each player get a subset of this x. So now, if we can design this assignment such that any user play together can have all the secret seed in this x, and t or few players cannot do so in this one, then you are done. Okay, so if you look at this, if t equals to u minus 1, exactly our CA case, or maybe GCA. But if t is not equal to u, then problem becomes much more complicated, become a bit hard, set kind of problem, but again, it's a combinatorial nature. Okay, you can try to generalize this CA or GCA case. Okay, so this is the pseudo-random function. You can also for the pseudo block cipher. Okay, again, block cipher here is block cipher. You don't have the homomorphic property. So in Berkeley et al. In 2000, they come up with this idea. So instead of original key space, you extend this key space from k to k power h, and then define a new block. So-called H-fold composition, and it's approved by, I think, like by Mao, show that this is indeed secure as secure as underlying this one. And then this time, you simply can share this K1 to KD use this CA or GCA. Okay, so, again, for the method of authentication, you can almost do the same thing. For this mark, and this time we have expanded this key the key space from k to k to power d, and then we share the key k1 to kd using the CA or GCA. Okay, so this is the first part I'm going to cover for this perfect Huaxiong family in the applications. So I'm going to move to second part, so cryptography family, combinatorial object in application sequencing scheme and our key distribution. So, look at this simple case. Assume there are T users in the network, and each page of them would like to have a secure communication, and assume a key distribution center enable secure communication by assigning each page of user a key, right? And this time, you have required T choose two possible pair for possible key, and each user needed to have T minus one to one key. So this is the so-called well-known N-square network problem. Okay, so the idea is that mature pipe in ATA, they come up with this idea. So instead of giving each user independent key, so we can get this key distribution center to get a set of n key, and each user get a subset of key. So now user this time now user PIPJ can construct a new key based on the intersection of B I and BJ. Now in order to prevent the advisory collusion attack, now if you have imposed this requirement, intersection of BIBJ cannot be covered by any other T subset of the union BJ, then you are done. You have this secure communication. So now in later 80s, Stinson come up with a more general definition of this one. It's okay for you can generalize this also as T cover preferably by in this way. So you have a set of any event, and each user get a subset of them, and then you have what we call this ST covered with family if this condition is satisfied. So intersection of BI from